Dear friends, today we are going to discuss about Dynamic Communication Manager DCM. DCM is all about dynamic request and response. Dynamic request handling is performed by DCM module of AutoSAR. Sister or client send dynamic request to the ECU, or ECU send response to the client or tester, which is handled by the DCM. DCM validate the incoming request and process whether it is valid or invalid request. If the request is valid, and DCM will send the positive response. If request is not valid, DCM will send to the negative response. And also DCM check security level and session access and whether service is supported or not, and message format, valid length also, and so on. Here you can see dynamic request and response flow. When request from tester tool received by the PDR, PDR will transmit to the Dynamic Communication Manager. Dynamic Communication Manager take the action on requested message and it will transmit to application layer with the help of RTE. So in this video we will discuss about especially for Dynamic Communication Manager and at this submodule. Dynamic Communication Manager is subdivided into three parts. One is Dynamic Session Layer, DSL. Second one is Dynamic Service Dispatcher, DST. Third one is Dynamic Service Processor, DSP. Functionality of DSL. DSL communicate with PDR and accept incoming dynamic request from PDR and send that request to DST and receive response from DST and send to that response to PDR. Few functionalities are: implement concurrent tester present logic, keep track of current session. Say for example, if current session is non-default session, then it will check for server timeout, and if server timeout occur, then it will automatically move to default session. Then handling different dynamic protocol, it will distinguish OBD, OBD and UDS protocol. And DSL is responsible for NRC 78. NRC 70 is nothing but pending. And protocol timing parameter P2 and P2 star also. Functionality of DST. DST module receive the request from DSL and validate the service request and send that request to DSP and gather response and send to DST. Few functionalities are: check security and session access of incoming request. Say for example, ECU in default session, but tester send request which is should be executed in extended dynamic session. In the sense, DST will send NRC 7F service, which is nothing but service not supported in active session. And second point, send positive response and negative response or suppress response. Third one is check whether service is supported or not. Say for example, any of the service is not configured, in the sense it will send NRC 11. For example, SAD 22 is not configured, in the sense DST will send NRC 11, service not supported. DST module collect positive response or negative response from DSP module and add service identifier and relevant response data from the application and forward this to DSL. Functionality of DSP. DSP receives service request from DST module and perform check and execute some particular action based on the request, and it may get some data from DEM or SW application layer and assemble the all the positive response and send to the DST. Few functionalities are: once message received from the DST and check the message format, if it is not valid and it will send the NRC 13. Second point is check subfunction supported or not. If the subfunction is not supported, in the sense it will send the NRC 12. And service third one is service implementation. This is nothing but implementation of UDS and OBD. Next video we will discuss about remaining part. Thanks for watching.